What's going on, everybody? I'm Jory Goodman, the Time Teller. So guys, in a few of my recent episodes, I've been talking about various quartz watches, and whenever I talk about quartz watches, inevitably I bring up my beloved Seiko Tuna, because in my opinion, the Seiko Tuna is the pinnacle of quartz success. It's tough, it's durable, it's really well made with a really solid 7C46 quartz movement. And whenever I talk about that watch, I get a lot of people in my comment section asking me for viable alternatives when it comes to super durable, well-made quartz watches. Now, one company that I get all the time is G-Shock, right? G-Shock, they're battery-powered, solar-powered. People want to know if that's a really tough, durable watch. Well, of course, I think their track record speaks for itself. Another company I hear about all the time in my comment section is Luminox. And let's face it, Luminox really does market themselves as a durable, tough, well-made, mil-spec, Navy SEAL watch manufacturer. So is it a tool or is it a toy? It's 2:57 p.m. Let's get down to business. Okie dokie, so Luminox, tool or toy? Well, believe it or not, I own one and it's here on my wrist right now. I did a little unboxing of it here, my 25th anniversary Navy SEAL reference number 3057. I gotta be honest, okay? My thoughts on Luminox have evolved throughout the years. When I first started out watch collecting, I actually had a couple Luminox Navy SEAL watches and I thought they were super duper badass. I mean, Navy SEALs are as badass as they come. But as I learned more about watches, and as I learned more about what I want to see from watches, and as I learned about what truly makes up a super durable watch, the less I thought of Luminox as a true tool watch, and the more it became more of a toy. Here's what I mean. Okay, so whether or not Luminox actually uses the term mil-spec in their marketing, they have the freaking Navy SEAL insignia on the case back of their Navy SEAL watches. What could be more mil-spec than that, right? Well, there's a little adage in the marketing world. If it's mil-spec, it's marketing. And let's face it, okay, the US Navy SEALs, they spend a whole lot of time in and around water. And for a watch that is a Navy SEAL watch, it doesn't even have a threaded crown. I know people are gonna bark at me through the comments. You don't need a threaded crown to have a nice water resistance rating. Well, that's true, but there are a lot of watches that are less expensive than this that do have the same water resistance rating than this that are also tougher than this because they have a threaded crown. I've said it a million times, threaded crowns don't just enhance the water resistance, they also ensure that you don't freaking open the crown, that the crown doesn't accidentally open, and that you don't knock the crown, breaking the crown stem off into the movement. But okay, this Luminox Navy SEAL does have a listed 200 meter water resistance rating, and let's say that the crown was nice, sturdy, it had a positive click in and out, and it wouldn't move at all. We would be fine with that, right? Well, that's not the case with this watch. The crown on this Luminox Navy SEAL, it moves around a ton. There's little to no resistance with it. I can wiggle it around. I can rotate it. I can push and pull it out and in of the crown. And there's really, again, no tangible, discernible, positive click in or out. And that kind of doesn't instill any confidence whatsoever in this watch's water resistance rating. It just doesn't feel very Navy SEAL to me. Another thing that has come to bother me with this watch is the polycarbonate. Okay, polycarbonate is pretty impact resistant. It's pretty tough and durable, but it doesn't absorb knocks the way that G-Shock's resin does, and it doesn't feel nearly as sturdy as like a stainless steel watch does. Heck, my titanium watches feel more durable than this. This literally feels like a plastic watch, and that's essentially what polycarbonate is. To put it plainly, it feels cheap. Now, probably my least favorite part about this watch, aside from that terrible crown, is the bezel. Okay, the bezel, it sounds nice, right? It has a very positive click. I wish that the crown had that. It just feels like a toy. It feels cheap, okay? Aside from that nice positive ratcheting, you can wiggle it around. Everything about this watch feels like something you would give a kid, and it makes sense because I got these watches when I was much younger. But aside from Luminox using the Navy SEALs as like a big marketing ploy, one of their other claims to fame is tritium, right? They make tritium watches, very, very cool and not super duper common nowadays. Well, I'd love to show you an awesome kind of tritium loom shot, but it doesn't exist. This watch does not glow at all. all. So when you factor in the wobbly crown and the flimsy bezel and the all-around light, cheap feel, and then the zero low-light capability that comes from that tritium that is just dead, and you compare it to that US Navy SEAL insignia on the back, it just doesn't add up. Or I should say, what it does add up to is a toy. This is a toy. A toy that initially cost $550. So in my opinion, an overpriced toy. Now I know I'm gonna get some questions about the movement. This doesn't have what I would consider a no-name movement. It actually uses a Ronda 1 Joule movement. And you know, that's fine, it's accurate, it's precise. One thing I don't really like about the markings on the chaptering is that it's kind of hard to read. So instead of the second hand landing on each marker, it lands on either side of the marker, but it's happening on every marker, so at least it's congruent, but I don't really like that. Now, I actually have some footage of that movement because I actually had to change the battery on this watch because when I went to go and make this episode, the watch was dead. And for those of you who don't want to watch the initial review of this Luminox Navy SEAL, here's some extra information. So it has a 42.8 millimeter diameter. Now, what's tricky about that is normally when we measure the diameter, we go at the widest part of the watch, excluding the crown and crown guards. Well, this watch also has this extra little chunk that sticks out here. So it's 42.8 millimeters, but when we factor in this other little piece of material and the crown, it's about 48.5. So at the thickest point all around, it's 48.5 millimeters. The watch has got a 48.4 millimeter lug to lug, so I'm a bigger dude. I have 7.5 inch wrists. This watch will wear large if you have smaller wrists than myself. And the watch is 14.3 millimeters thick at the thickest point. Now, what bothers me about that is this is a quartz watch, okay? I have automatics that are thinner than this. But for a watch that is supposed to be super duper tactical, that's a little bit chunky. So in conclusion, when I first learned about Luminox, yes, it was a tool watch. The more I learned about watches in general, it became a toy. But I must say, I do have some very fond memories of my Luminox Navy SEAL watches. I know my dad thought they were really cool, so they kind of remind me of him as well. They are cool watches. They're fun watches to give to a kid. They're gonna be fairly tough. One thing that kind of also bothers me about this watch is this one, that hasn't been worn all that much, already has some fairly deep scuffs on the mineral crystal. That's right, it's a mineral crystal. They didn't even put sapphire. So again, guys, they didn't even put like much effort in making this super durable. They didn't even give it very durable attributes. So yeah, there are watches with better attributes, better specs that are less expensive. So look elsewhere. But guys, I'd love to hear from you. I'm sure some of you feel differently than me. Leave that in the comment section and I'd love to hear from you there. And if you're new here, I want to say thank you so much for subscribing. There's a whole bunch more content on the way. So please click that subscribe button, click the bell icon so you don't miss out on anything. Check out the links in the description below. We have a bunch of really cool watch related gear there. It'll take you to my Amazon affiliate store. Join the channel if you want to go above and beyond. And yeah, like, comment, subscribe, share this with everyone you know so they don't waste their money on a Luminox. I'm Jory Goodman, the time teller. Always remember, I didn't invent time, I just tell it. What is the deal with ASMR?